If you are without fear, said the peasant, stay with me and help me to watch that grave there.
To keep watch is a soldier's business, he replied. Whatever we fall in with here, whether it be good or bad, we will share it between us.
The peasant agreed to this, and they seated themselves on the grave together. All was quiet until midnight, when suddenly a shrill whistling was heard in the air, and the two watchers perceived the evil one standing bodily before them.
Be off, you ragamuffins, cried he to them. The man who lies in that grave belongs to me. I want to take him, and if you don't go away, I will wring your necks.
Sir, with a red feather, said the soldier, you are not my captain. I have no need to obey you, and I have not yet learned how to fear. Go away, we shall stay sitting there.
The devil thought to himself, money is the best thing with which to get hold of these two vagabonds. So he began to play a softer tune and asked quite kindly if they would not accept a bag of money and go home with it.
That is worth listening to, answered the soldier. But one bag of gold won't serve us. If you will give as much as will go into one of my boots, we will quit the field for you and go away.
I have not so much as that about me, said the devil, but I will fetch it. In the neighboring town lives a money changer who is a good friend of mine and will readily advance it to me.
When the devil had vanished, the soldier took his left boot off and said,
we will soon pull the charcoal burner's nose for him. Just give me your knife, comrade.
He cut the sole off the boot and put it in the high grass near the grave on the edge of a hole that was half overgrown.
That will do, said he. Now the chimney sweep may come.
They both sat down and waited, and it wasn't long before the devil returned with a small bag of gold in his hand.
Just pour it in, said the soldier, raising up the boot a little. But that won't be enough.
The black one shook out all that was in the bag. The gold fell through, and the boot remained empty.
Stupid devil, cried the soldier. It won't do, didn't I say so at once? Go back again and bring more.
The devil shook his head, went, and in an hour's time came with a much larger bag under his arm.
Now pour it in, cried the soldier, but I doubt the boot won't be full.